Hello there, listener. Just Nathan here. Thank you for choosing to listen to another episode of the Prawn Sandwich Podcast. Before we get into today's episode, I'm going to give you a quick mention of our newest sponsor. Irvine's Mobility in Carlisle, Cumbria have a range of new and used mobility equipment and specify in wheelchairs and mobility scooters. You can find them on Facebook by searching Irvine's Mobility, or you can find them on their website at www.irvinesmobility.co.uk. That's irvinesmobility.co.uk. For sales, repairs, or any queries you may have, just ask for Paul. That's Irvine's Mobility, Modern Mobility Solutions, sponsors of the Prawn Sandwich Podcast.
Hi, I'm Mark Crossley, and you're listening to the Prawn Sandwich Podcast.
How's the bacon, did you say?
Nathan Cupid, and joined by Jamie Jackson and Dylan McKenzie.
Hello, boys.
Hello.
How are we doing, gents?
I'm good. Had a
wonderful.
Had a bit of a rough day at the old football manager, but apart from that,
yeah. Let's get into our saves. Get into our saves. So, Jay, you can lead since it's.
Well, if anybody was listening last time, will know I've had a save with Heart on FM21 that I've kept going a while. Just finished the 27-28 season, and I've been saying for ages that if I manage to win a European trophy with Heart, this will probably be my best save on Football Manager that I've had, especially because the newer ones are a bit harder than what they used to be. So, after getting it, finishing third in my Champions League group, dropping into the Europa League, I thought, great chance of winning this tournament. Long story short, because you boys, as obviously know, I made it to the final after an epic comeback from 2-0 down against Arsenal in the semis as well. I thought it was written in the stars to do it. And I lost to Napoli 2-1 in the final, and I'm absolutely fucking gutted, to be honest. I had to go for a walk to clear my head. I think that's the save done.
Bless you.
After Esposito got 68 goals in 55 games or something in all competitions this season.
Trip to Tynecastle's going to be emotional now, isn't it?
I need to get a heart stop with Esposito on the back. But yeah, I'm not sure I'll be loading this save back up. I think I'll just wait till the new one's out now. I've took a lot out of us.
Done.
What about yous? What have yous got on the go at the minute?
Well, I'm back on Footy Manager now since work's absolutely shite. Because I work in a proper tourist spot, so nothing's going on at the minute. So I've even started chasing the dragon at work and taking my laptop down to work.
That's phenomenal.
To get a kick on the end of the bar, play Footy Manager. Got my Depo one back up, sacked my Roma one off, got my Depo one back up since I'm in Europe. Well, I had to qualify for Europe, but I did. I beat Heron Veen in the qualifiers 4-1 on aggregate. Signed all these players, had a busy window thinking, oh, I'll get into Europe, I'll sign a big squad. Signed about 3 centre mids, and I still can't drop the indispensable British pair of Conor Hourihan and Trevor Calabar. signed a few Spaniards, signed a Peruvian, signed a Italian, and they just don't even get a look in. But like, what's funny is Hirohan's like 7 points for the season so far. It's only six games in. Scored five goals in all competitions and can't get an Ireland squad.
How old is he now?
On mine, 32, 33.
I thought it'd be older than it.
No, I'm only fourth season. Yeah, fourth season, 32, 33, but he can't get in there. I haven't even clicked on their squad, but I'm pure tempted because like, they must have some unbelievable footballers in that Ireland midfield to keep him out. Dominating the league, man. But yeah, other than that, just won my first European game away at St. Johnstone 4-0 and haven't been on since. So sit my place on tonight, see how I feel.
What about you, Nathan?
Well, I sacked my Napoli one off.
You're going to be a safe haul, like.
It's just a DOS. It's going too well.
You said, I'm not enjoying it because it's going too well.
Yeah, like, beat Juve, beat Inter, beat AC Milan. The only game I've lost is I lost 1-0 to Leicester in the Europa League. So I thought, start a new one. So a fortnight ago, I started a one with Darlington. And I'm pure addicted to this one. Yeah, flying. Unbeaten in the league. David Waiter at St. Ralph. Knocked out the FA Cup. That's before it even starts.
Standard. For somebody that loves the FA Cup so much, it doesn't love you at all.
It's ridiculous. Nah. Ridiculous, but it is what it is. We crack on. Up the Quakers.
We're going to end up going to a Darlington game before the end of the season, aren't we? No.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah. No, absolutely. Going to a Hearts game in a month's time. That'll be, like you say, be an emotional trip. fucking hell.
Do we have to do it now? You're not doing the save anymore.
Oh, we've bought the tickets now. Could be a sellout, yeah. Man. Hearts versus Livingston. It's just about the sellout.
Oh, yeah. Forgot about that.
Good that. What about Fantasy Prem? Are you still sticking in it or what? Like,
I'm still doing it, but I'm doing shit. Bill's flying.
I look at it, but I don't change anything.
I looked at the end of last week, but I was both leagues. I'm in a Sunderland fans league and I'm in our league, and I was top of both.
Dill's absolutely flying.
I got lucky. Like, I did random shit like. Rashford got injured and I took him up for Trossard and then he went and bagged a hatty at Anfield. I was like, sound.
Phenomenal though.
Yeah, I'm still top of both leagues.
How it goes off with Fantasy Premier League. You just pick plays, don't you?
I'm doing great. I need a Serie B one.
Serie B.
Did you see? We're going to do that Serie B save, and like we were debating who would go. And obviously, I've got the Palermo ban, even though they're fourth bottom in real life. But when we were picking teams, like Dill was like Bari, so I was like, oh, I'll go Brescia. You contemplated Regina at one point, Nath.
Yes.
Right, the top three of Serie B: Regina are top, Bari are second, and Brescia are third.
Class.
Love it.
We know our stuff, like...
Como is struggling, which is good to see.
Good.
Don't be like that, man.
Fuck Dennis Wise, man.
Till he's gone, I'm not happy.
See, the thing is, like, I'd love to go to a Como game because the location of the stadium's absolutely...
It's phenomenal.
Unreal. It's unreal. I'd love to go. But...
Just can't begrudge bumping into it.
Yeah. by the way, if you hear little squeaks and grumbles, I've got Humbug in the room with us. So, listeners, that's my dog. So she might be part of the podcast today. She's been a little pest. Right, Dill, do you want to tell us, everybody, what we're doing?
Yes.
Yes. So we're trying to like just speculate ideas that maybe the pods don't do, but, well, someone might have done this, but we just thought three top leagues, in our opinion, Serie A, La Liga, and the Prem. So we've all took a league each and done an all-time 11. When I say all-time, I'm guessing most of ours is going to be from the years of 1990, before everyone kicks off saying Like, why isn't, I don't know, Maradona and that in there?
Yeah, our lifetime.
Yeah, so
and it's we're all going to say
our 11 after much debate. This was actually a debate, we're not even joking. We all had decided we had to do the same formation, so we didn't have to start tinkering with that. So we have to do 4-2-3-1.
I'm not best players, but...
I ended up with La Liga, Nath has the Premier League, and Jay has Serie A. And we're going to go through position by position and argue what the final all-time 11 between the three leagues should be. Obviously, people listening might disagree, but make your own podcast and do what you want, if that's how you do it.
Another thing we said was, like you said in the chat, Dil, like, it's got to be somebody that was good in that league and not just somebody that went there for a season.
Yeah. So, for example, explaining that is, I think we won't even mint. Say Jay picks Ibrahimovic from AC Milan and Inter, fair shout. But if Nave said Man United Ibrahimovic, it'd have to be Man United Ibrahimovic. I'm not saying he was bad, but like nowhere near the best of all time.
Yeah.
So it would be debated on what his time in the Premier League, not overall career. So that's how it goes. And for La Liga purposes, I wasn't allowed to choose Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo.
I have to take it seriously.
Yeah, and they've had to take it seriously and not put in Dion Dublin. Or it still might have, to be honest. But
I've tried not to let my heart rule my head with this, to be honest. I've tried to... I've actually tried to do it properly, which is why I got quite frustrated at the formation.
I've had to pick Barca players.
I've went through loads of different formations, loads of different... mine's going to upset a fair few people, I'd still say.
Right, so should we get started off then?
Yeah, go on then.
So, in goals, I am going to rule myself out of this because my keeper picked, obviously, was easy, but the allegations of the last week, I decided to... just basically fuck him.
Like, fair play.
I'm not going to act like I'm the most straightforward person in the world and stick up for everyone's rights, but I think what Iker Casillas and Puyol did was a disgrace on Twitter to, like, the LG, whatever you want to call it. See, that's why I'm not straight-laced, but you know what I mean? Saying he's gay, seeing he's gay when he's not is when, especially when, like, people like that Josh De Silva came out in football saying he's gay, can't be right for anyone, so... my keeper would be Iker Casillas. I didn't see the point in subbing him out for another keeper that I don't truly believe is the best. That's why I didn't do it. So I'll say Iker Casillas, but I will happily vote one of yours.
Respect, Dil.
Fair play. I love it.
It was more the risk, like, obviously it was like minging what they did and like just no thought behind it. But the replies to it were fucking doggo. Absolutely minging.
Yeah. But anyway, then saying I was hacked. No, you weren't.
I know. Like, just own up to your mistake, man. He said he was hacked and then Puyol had already tweeted, like, oh, it was a bad joke. It's like, fucking hell. God's sake.
Yeah, so, Casillas. He's out. That's mine for having to put someone in. I did think about going Zubizarreta, but I thought he ain't going to get any others. So...
right, well, I've gone for Gigi Buffon.
I've got a feeling you'll win this one.
That was just easy for me to concede as well, I'm not going to lie.
Like, what can you say about Buffon? Longevity, is still playing now, albeit in Serie B, and sparingly in Serie B. He doesn't,
I'm going to say it.
Yeah, I think he's played once this season. He didn't play when we went. That was absolutely gutted.
Heartbroken.
But
he must have got injured because the game I've seen that he played, he went off in like the 68th minute or something. So I was like, oh, he's injured again.
Yeah. Hang on a sec. One sec, lads. Bubble's kicking off. She doesn't agree with Buffon, it seems. Oh, for fuck's sake.
To be fair, he doesn't really need to argue that. So, Nate, who have you got?
I chose Edwin van der Sar.
Oh, shout.
That's a good shout, to be fair.
As much as everyone will go like Schmeichel and all that, but so you got David Seaman and all that, and David James, Petr Cech. But I think the simple fact that Man United was shit until they signed him, and then they were mint, and now they're shit again. And he was decent as well, to be fair.
He'd be my Premier League number one.
I just think it's mint at the fact that he was good at Ajax. He went to Italy, and he was, let's face it, he was cat. And then no one else wanted him, so he's gone to Fulham, and he's been decent at Fulham. And then there's only one club that he could have gone to, really, and it was Man United. And he was mint, won them a Champions League, so...
He'd be mine. I don't, like you already know, I don't really get the Schmeichel thing. And him or prime Czech would be my Premier League ones.
It was torn between Van der Sar and Czech.
I think because of Czech trying to like hold out at Arsenal, Van der Sar would get the nod. So I think that's the right choice. But I'm gonna go with Buffon.
Yeah, it's gotta be Gigi, isn't it?
It's just a shame he never won the Champions League,
our
two goalkeepers have.
Yeah.
Buffon's won a World Cup.
Yeah, that is true.
So's mine.
I know it's
it's just a gay basher.
Yeah. So is Buffon in?
Gigi Buffon goes in at the six. Right. So we're gonna move on to right back, lad. People might think he's pathetic for me again, but I have also backed out because I don't think there's many in history at league that are that good at right back in the Liga. So I put Puyol there for the same reasons. I am giving up a spot again. I couldn't think. I was like, Carvajal, he's the mainstay, you think. And then I'm one of these. I don't like Dani Alves. Just don't like him.
I think
he fit a system a lot. A bit like he's better, but like a bit like Trent, the argument now. Mm. How many games did he really have to defend when he was at when he was at prime Barca?
Yeah,
he just didn't. He was in all team of the years for like until basically he couldn't walk and it was just like eh. But no, I'll bow down. And this time, if Nath, you want to go first?
I've gone for Pablo Zabaleta.
Nice shout.
Workhorse. I think with Man City full of stars, doesn't really get much shine on him, to be fair.
He played for Espanyol, though. Could be winning it.
I could easily pick Gary Neville, but like not having it.
See, I would argue that I know people say Gary Neville because right back is not thingy. I would argue you would put Kyle Walker over Gary Neville now.
Yeah. I think
I think you're right, not putting Gary Neville.
Yeah, completely. Zabaleta's only just recently retired as well. So, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, West Ham. Bloody hell.
Yeah, that was a bit that kind of let me down a bit, like at West Ham. But I thought Zabaleta at West Ham is still better than
Zabaleta.
Yeah, he's still better than retirement age Gary Neville. Plus, when I was doing it, my dad was like, if you have Neville over Zabaleta, I won't speak to you. So, so I've got Zabaleta.
Because like there were so many stars that have played for Man City, like attacking stars over the past 10 years or whatever, it kind of goes under the radar, doesn't it? How important Zabaleta was in those
class.
Early years.
He scored in that Aguero game, albeit a deflection.
Did I?
My right back's a bit more glamorous, to be fair. Cafu.
Oh, this is unfair.
it was a tough call between him and Zanetti. The fact Cafu was part of the Roma side that won Serie A in 2001 swung it for me. Like, never mind, like, two World Cup wins as well, but If we're going like what they were like in Italy, then it was Cafu for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm pretty much bought now since I've dropped out. I have to go with Cafu.
It'll have to be Cafu, like, won't it?
Yeah. It's hard not to.
Sorry, Zabba.
So Cafu was put in at right back.
Two for two for me.
Yeah. Right now. I'm allowed to argue. Do you want to go centre half across the back or do you want to go left back?
Left back.
Left back?
Yeah.
I think we win again, innit?
There's only one choice. There's only one choice for me.
Well, you may as well say yours.
Paolo Maldini.
See, I'm having an argument here.
Do you know what?
I'm having Ashley Cole. As a left back of a Paolo Maldini. And I love Paolo Maldini.
Well, mine technically the most... I'm trying to think of the word. Actually, no, Ashley Cole might run him close, trophy-wise.
What, the most decorated?
That's the word. I got Marcelo.
That's a good shout as well.
I think he's better than Roberto Carlos, even though no one wants to admit it, because he didn't score free kicks. Just left Real Madrid. People forget 2007 to 2022. He was signed before Ronaldo and all that, the year before. 6 La Ligas, 5 Super Cups, 5 Champions Leagues. Scored in Champions League final.
That's a strong argument, to be fair. Strong argument. Like, most of, like, if we're going off our lifetime, like, I must admit, like, I can't really argue on Maldini did it over, like, 80s, early 90s and that as well, because...
You can. I just... The reason I said at the time, like, time was just people don't get offended if I, like, haven't got... Do you know what I said?
Yeah.
Nathan ain't got George Best in the middle, and I haven't got, I don't know, like I said, Maradona up front.
Maldini, 7 league titles, 5 Champions League / European Cups. Only ever won 1 Coppa Italia, 5 Super Coppas, 2 Intercontinental Cups, and 1 FIFA World Club Cup. 5 European Super Cups. Played until he was 39. Still massing over 30 games a season as a 39-year-old and was right-footed.
Nath, when you cast your vote, remember that Marcelo plays for Olympiacos now, who you had a good manager.
I'm still trying to get Ashley Cole in there, me, man. 1 Champions League, 3 Premier Leagues, Europa League, 7 FA Cups, 1 League Cup, 6 Community Shields, if that counts. A stalwart at left back since what, like 99 till whenever he retired. When did he retire from international football? England's most capped left back, probably the best left back in the world at some point.
Definitely,
he could keep Cristiano Ronaldo in his pocket when Ronaldo was in his peak in the Premier League.
Oh, Nath's made a shout, you know. I'm gonna fold with Marcelo. I'd take Ashley Cole over Marcelo.
He crossed the London. You know, he went from Arsenal, he went from being an invincible at Arsenal, and he could have went anywhere, but he went to Chelsea with Mourinho and just smashed it up.
Yeah, he didn't have to move house.
Exactly. And everyone that came, shot
a kid with an air rifle.
I'm going Ashley Cole, like, as much as I love Paolo Maldini, like, I'd have Maldini at centre half.
His old chair had an aura. In the changing rooms when we were there.
Yeah, no, I didn't even touch it.
We've never been to Stamford Bridge. You can't say that.
I'm not counting to Stamford Bridge. Just to see where Ashley Cole sat.
Where does Ashley Cole sit?
Oh, it's not the same. Not the same. My hand doesn't feel as warm.
How do I get out early? I don't want to see the rest of the tour. I've been the churn off.
I'll give you that one, Mike. There was an aura. I do love Maldini, man. But Ashley Cole's Ashley Cole.
Paolo Maldini's Paolo Maldini. Paolo Maldini over Ashley Cole every day of the week.
We've not had an Englishman.
I'm not like pro-England, but like I think it's like the only chance to get an Englishman in there.
Ashley Cole, to be fair, was probably England's like one of maybe 3 genuine world-class players that we had for an extended period of time.
It's a weird one with Ashley Cole because I didn't put Gary Neville in because you could just go, well, he's like the only decent right back that England's ever had. But you could say that about Ashley Cole.
Ashley Cole is 12 times the
player. I don't like Gary Neville.
12 times the player than Gary Neville is like.
Yeah, completely. Left footed as well.
He ruined a Geordie's life as well. That's a good statement.
I'm not conceding Paolo Maldini to Ashley Cole. Sorry, it's probably even now as technical director at AC Milan, he's helping them win Scudettos, and he's still fucking tidy and all.
true. You know what Ashley Cole's doing now? he's on the Everton. He's on the Everton stuff, isn't he? Yeah. Fair enough.
I might have to give you to Maldini now with that.
Right, we'll give it a Maldini, but we have to step up now because he's got three players in already.
We've let our Italian connections like rule this a bit.
I think centre backs is where it's going to start getting a bit contested now.
Right, so we've got it centre half. Yeah. Are you putting your strongest of the two first or your weakest?
Oh God, it's hard to say who's a stronger and weaker one. I know who your stronger one will be.
No, you don't. who's starting?
Save your strongest for the second one. So go with your alleged less stronger one.
So I'll go first. I haven't been first yet, have I? Or did I go first last? No, Nate went first, didn't he? Oh no, you said yours because it was obviously Maldini.
I would.
Right, I'll go first. And this might raise your eyebrows a bit. Obviously, I didn't want Puyol after what happened. It would have been Puyol if it was, so I shoved him to right back. And I don't rate his mate PK. We all know my version, my things on that. Mine is, people might not know, they'll know him for one club, but he's actually a La Liga stalwart. Because before I went to this team, he played 91 games for Villarreal. I have gone for guy who, along with a few others, transformed the team into probably the most defensive team in the world. Diego Godin, Atletico Madrid. Conquered the Barca-Real dominance, winning the Liga. Didn't win one, but got to two Champions League finals. This is what I'm saying. He's like probably one of those ones that's changed Atleti into a powerhouse, along with Griezmann and Koke, Gabi. But yeah, 277 games for Atleti, 91 for Villarreal over that time. I just think he's pure underrated. And he got in like one team of the year one time, or two. And I get it. Everyone wants to love Barca and Real Madrid, and Atleti aren't fashionable, but what a defender. Like, yeah, 6'6", 6'7". Head on anything. Champions League final goal as well. Yeah. Was like 30 seconds away from winning the Champions League until my centre back partner next to him went and scored the equaliser. I just think he's pure underrated. I think he's absolutely class. He was so good. He probably floated off quicker than most do. Like his Inter Milan thing wasn't great, and he ended up at Calgary, and I think he's, I don't know where he's in now, to be honest. I read it today and I can't remember.
Is that back in like Uruguay or something? Or Brazil or something?
Maybe, yeah. But just absolute stalwart, that Atleti team. And I think that's like an unbelievable footballer. Scored the goal that won the league as well at the Camp Nou, last game of the season from a corner. Just an absolute Atleti legend. So that's my first one, lads.
Fair play.
You go next, Niff.
I start with the weaker of the two. Right, go on then. My weaker of the two is John Terry. Player football, solid defender, leader, can pop up with the odd goal.
Racist.
Yeah. It's a football thing.
Yeah, I know.
Dill took the moral high ground of like homophobes, and Nathan includes a racist.
it's on football. What happens outside of football?
It's all right. It's all right. You don't have to.
Nah,
we
unbelievable.
Don't have to dig into that. I'll fight JT's corner.
Unbelievable footballer.
And he just pipped Jonathan Woodgate, to be fair. joking.
Another one with a clean slate.
Woody had nothing to do with that.
I've lost my train of thought. No, John Terry. What can you say about John Terry, really? Like, as a footballer, fair enough. He didn't technically win his Champions League winners medal, did he? But he's won one. And yeah, he's won everything that there is to win domestically, isn't there? So, captain, he'll score not important goals, but he can get a couple of goals a season, and he can actually play football as well. And he can also get in the ref's ear, which is very important. Very important.
I genuinely don't know who I could pick as the weaker one of my pair. A few years ago, I would have picked one as the better one. But as I've got older, I've appreciated the other one a bit more. So I'm going to... The one I'd class slightly just under would be Fabio Cannavaro. Similar to Buffon. Same as Buffon. Won everything with Parma that they won in the 90s. UEFA Cups. Coppa Italia is obviously just shy in the league. Went to Inter. He was one of the last to leave Parma as well. Went to Inter, was there for a couple of seasons before going to Juve. Winning Serie A, etc. with Juve. Winning the World Cup with Italy. Got to a Champions League final. Never won it though. Fabio Cannavaro.
Talking just in their league, Serie A, I would take John Terry for a longevity. I think they're both quite similar in their football style. I would. Cannavaro's good though.
We've had far too many Italians, man.
I know, but that's because they're good in defence. he might struggle once we get out of there, but
you're not conceding.
Goal scoring, though.
Cannavaro was a bit erratic at Madrid. I know you're not arguing for La Liga, but he was a bit erratic at Madrid.
We've got goal scoring defenders here, man.
You're not conceding with my defenders.
Atleti won every game like 1-0.
John Terry's John Terry.
I could
concede John Terry to your two, to be fair. But I will fight the corner in my next one.
I think it's going to be quite a battle for the next one, I think. Depends how stubborn we all are.
Are we being for real?
I got Gordon. Gordon's a good shout, you know. But then again, Cannavaro
captain. I know it's time at City.
Berlin Wall and all that.
Captained Italy to a World Cup.
And he's beautiful.
And manager of Benevento now.
I would take Cannavaro over Gordon. Not doing great myself here, but then I would take Terry over Cannavaro. But then I would take my other one over all of them. I'm going to stump my dummy if that one, my next one, doesn't get in the team. You just know that.
Oh, man. I'm happy to come to
you. I'm sweating Terry, I'm not going to lie.
Just going to say this. You see, we've put our weak ones first. Should we then talk about our stronger ones and pick two out of all six?
Two, yeah.
Pick a solid two. I like that.
Go on then. Greatest centre-half to ever live. Sergio Ramos. Not even a debate. It's not even a debate. It's just stupid how good he was. But I get it. People want to hate him because he's been sent off 40 billion. No, he got sent off for the 20th time in his career on the weekend.
He did, didn't he?
Yeah. Okay. But he didn't even do anything. Some stupid French ref couldn't take him talking at him. And he shaved his head again. So he looked unbelievably tidy.
He's an absolute beast.
He went through that period of taking free kicks and pins for Real Madrid.
That's what I'm saying. It's just 72 goals for Real Madrid.
A converted right back as well.
Yeah. He was going to be my right back, maybe, for a bit. But then I thought Real Madrid's more longevity was that centre half. 5 Ligas, 4 Champions League, 3 Super Cups. Unbelievable footballer. 72 goals, man. I know he started taking pens on Ronaldo there, but 72 and like big goals as well. Like, yeah, he's got no Barca, Champions League final. He's got two Champions League finals. Just got a Champions League final pen shootout.
Nah, it's...
Well, I take him over the past three.
Do you know what? And Jay's mentioned it, so I'm mentioning it. He's won the World Cup, Euros twice.
Yeah. As a right back.
No, World Cup, he was centre half. First Euros, he's right back.
Was it not Puyol and...
No, he swapped in a bit. That was the first one where they swapped the team around a little bit.
All right. I'm not going to argue with you with Spain. my better of my two, Alessandro Nesta.
Well, I'm just writing Ramos down in the final thing.
Alessandro Nesta, two Champions League wins, two Serie A. That's with AC Milan. Won the Serie A with Lazio, their only league title since 1971. Another World Cup winner. And Inter Milan tried. Did you ever hear the story where Inter Milan had tried to sign him?
Yeah.
When they had Cannavaro there, and Ronaldo and Vieri were willing to take a pay cut to get Nesta to Inter, but Recoba was like, "No, I'm not budging, lads. I'm not budging."
Went fishing, took his phone off the.
You've got like a two-time Ballon d'Or winner and a fucking Vieri, who was most expensive player at the time, willing to take a pay cut to get Nesta there, and Recoba was having none of it.
He went on holiday, didn't he?
Aye.
I said no, went on holiday.
I'll give you Nesta club-wise, but his World Cup win...
Yeah, but he got injured early in the tournament, didn't he?
You can also tell Jay going on nostalgia. No Bonucci or Chiellini.
That is big.
But it's not as strong league. When I thought about... I did think about Chiellini, to be honest. I did. But, like, Serie A wasn't as strong as when Nesta was winning it. Wasn't?
You're banging about Serie B every week to us.
No, I'm not putting Serie B players in, I quite happily admit the football standard in Serie B is shit. It's just fun to watch.
Well, I'm having my other centre half, Vincent Kompany.
Oh my
fucking
dear.
Hell!
Like, signed as a holding midfielder, and then goes back to play centre half.
Right, I'll drop Godin.
And he can score not just goals, but he'll score important goals. If there's an important match,
Man United, Leicester,
he'll pop his head or his boot somewhere, and that man will bleed to not concede.
I'm going to
probably the best centre half in Premier League history, period, ever. He's not done much on the international stage, I will give you that. But in a Manchester City shirt, you cannot question that man as a defender. He's the best defender to grace the Premier League. And I won't have anything said anyway.
I'll give you Ramos and Kompany, like, to be honest.
Can I just say I'm quite happy because I generally thought, because of Strictly Come Dancing, Nathan was going to have Tony out of it.
So did I. Big
Tony's in there, to be fair. It's tough.
I've got it down to Kompany or Cannavaro, me.
Ramos is definitely in. Ramos.
Ramos has to be in, like.
Yeah.
Ramos and Kompany.
Imagine the goals in that team, mate. Wow.
No, you're not conceding. If that's your back four, right? Cafu, Ramos, Kompany and Maldini.
You could put that in. Then you've got to get past two. You could put Cannavaro and Nesta in that, and Terry to be fair.
Yeah, Kompany.
Kompany is such a good shout because he's so underrated by like pundits and that. Like they all rate
him. Football but, as like, well. Like, when they say about footballer he was.
Premier League stalwart, he gets named like sixth or seventh, and it's like, oh shut up, man! He was unbelievable.
Put Van Dijk over him, man! Ridiculous.
And, like I know Nath's gonna kick off, but like. He did play with some crap centre half at City as well. Like he carried like Di Michele. That's going to kick off. But like,
please,
they had Jerome Boateng when he wasn't good before he went to Bayern.
Needham and Neuer.
less got. Like, he's played with some shit.
Yeah,
he was the only survivor, wasn't he, before the takeover? The last signing before the takeover, when he was a CDM.
Sven brought him in. So Sven knows a player when he sees one.
No, Mark Hughes signed him, wasn't it?
Mark Hughes.
Yeah, Sven had left. It was that summer.
It was the summer before.
Company and Zabaleta signed in the same summer.
Yeah, they were like the last. They were like the only two survivors.
Can't give it up, Mark Hughes.
Oh, you know what? Vincent Company.
Company has to be.
Yeah, I'm going with you. Sorry, Joe. That's a great
idea, lads.
You nearly had Nesta, to be fair, when I thought he was going to say Tony Adams.
No chance. Tony Adams is all Strictly now, mate.
Fair play. So far we have Gigi and Net, back four of Cafu, Sergio Ramos, the captain. Vincent Company and Paolo Maldini.
That's a solid five straight off the bat. Five.
You're not conceding goals.
Nah.
Ramos might get sent off, but
there's loads of goals and assists in that alone.
Yeah. And the rest, to be fair.
Right, so we have two at the base.
Mm-hmm.
Like we just had a little mess up there. Should we just argue again for the two?
Yes.
Yeah. Aye.
Right. Do you want to say both at once or just one at a time and then argue the next one in?
Go do them both. We'll get through it a little bit quicker, won't we?
Right. I'll go first. One of them might surprise you. One of them isn't flashy, but decorated to, like, probably more than most players out there. So first of all, I've got 457 appearances for Barcelona, 8 La Ligas, 7 Copa del Reyes, 3 Champions League, Sergio Busquets. To get a bit of balance in the team.
Yeah.
And alongside him, which could be the shock, and most people probably slag me off for this, but age is like a fine wine. Ballon d'Or winner, Luka Modric. I think he, even though he's older, has turned into like an unbelievable footballer. Already world class, and then turned into like now he dictates games.
I love that Modric show. Like,
yeah, I'm quite surprised still. To be fair, there was like the Xabi Alonso absence is quite surprising.
I said Nath had to take this serious. I went with like Xabi Alonso was unbelievable, but a lot of his unbelievable career, I'm happy to admit, was at Liverpool. And Modric signed for Madrid in 2012, still there.
Yeah.
Voted the worst signing of the season. And then look at him now. Like,
they're like most important player now.
Shitting themselves last night. Right, he was on the bench. Modric, get him on. Still plays for Croatia, man.
Yeah.
Like, I just think he's unbelievable. And he gets slated for that Ballon d'Or. It's like, yeah, he's only in a mood because for once Ronaldo and Messi didn't win it.
Mm.
Like, he carried Croatia. Yeah, it goes along for the Ballon d'Or, a lot for the Ballon d'Or sometimes when there's an international tournament. It used to matter until Ronaldo and Messi. Yeah. If someone had a international tournament.
Yeah. Well, Fabio Cannavaro won it in 2006.
Yeah, yeah. Until them two started scoring billions of goals a year, it was just like, if you won the World Cup, you've got a massive chance. Like, And he carried Croatia, won the Champions League with Madrid in that year, 5 times Champions League. Probably only thing to let him down, he's only won 3 La Ligas, but you could say that about a lot of Madrid players. But yeah, I think he's world class. And like, even though I hate Barca, you can't just, there's no denying Sergio Busquets is probably the best holding midfielder to ever live.
Yeah.
Guy's unbelievable. I was watching a video the other day, it was just about like his head turning. That sounds so boring. But it was just like about like, it was him and Xavi, to be fair. And it was like both of them like just getting cameras, just how much his head turns in a game. Like,
yeah.
Ridiculous. Like, it sounds such an easy thing, but it's like spatial awareness, man. Jesus. So they're my two.
Oofed. Out the cannon.
go on, Nath.
I've got to follow that. right, my first one. Heart ruled head with this one. I've gone with Roy Keane.
I know, it's weird. Thank you for that.
as much as people want to say, like, aggressive, kicks people all the time, but, like, people actually forget that Roy Keane could actually play football, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, absolute pivotal for that, for Man United.
Absolutely, especially in a time where it was 4-4-2 and not else.
Yeah, exactly. Up and down, he can get up and down all game. No worrying about him. The only thing you have to worry about is him keeping his head, which is... But even then, he would keep his head. It was very rare he would lose his rag and go mental. Like, Roy Keane, and he's a... like a...
The time he got sent off, you could argue, weren't really big games. Nah. Big game. He's a big game player. Like you say, he could keep his head big games. I know there's the Juventus yellow card, but that's a yellow card, you know what I mean? It's not sent off.
Yeah.
Watch the video of
Javi Alonso. Javi Alonso did that, like we're saying about Javi Alonso did that when Madrid were 3-0 up at Bayern.
All you know business. What I mean? He's all business and he's all about winning the game. There's watch that. If you watch the, you know, like they do the handshakes and all that, and when Man United win the treble, right? When they play Inter Milan, everyone wants to shake Roy Keane's hand, doesn't shake anyone's hand, just looks right at them like mint.
Ronaldo's doing his laces, isn't he?
He just walks past him.
He just walks past him because he's not looking at him.
Min quality, an absolute natural born leader, good in the tackle, vision of a pass, up and down. He could maybe pop up with the odd goal here and there, but he's another one that'll do anything just to get the W at the end of the game, to be fair.
I did like it. It's nothing to do with football, sorry. Did you see the video of him at the American football on Sunday?
Yeah, when he was getting pestered for a selfie.
But that proves, like, I've heard it was listening to the podcast, it proves that that isn't, he's this thing that it's a facade he's doing. It's not, it's just him.
Yeah, pure.
He didn't know the cameras on him there. And no. Someone tried to take him, and he's just like, I'm trying to watch a game.
Yeah.
It wouldn't exactly.
I'm trying to watch a game, leave it alone. Proves not a facade. I love the man, mate. Like, you've done it right.
Not enough positive light gets shone on him, to be fair, I don't think. A lot of people look at him as a footballer and just think six studs in your knees, but he's not like that at all. Not like that at all.
Nah. He played in the era where you could tackle him, that's all it is.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Next one.
My other holding midfielder is Yaya Toure.
Definition of box to box.
Just
pure.
Yaya Toure. Can you imagine anything worse than like a 7-foot giant with tree trunk legs running over you? You ain't stopping that.
I loved him, mate.
Like,
I did, but I'm still better off he shot. Did he fuck?
It's a cross. It's a cross. It's not a shot. It's a cross.
Yeah.
But what a football player. What a football player. Just don't forget his birthday.
He's on a staff somewhere now, isn't he? Tottenham. Have I got that wrong?
I think it is.
Yeah.
And he's somewhere, isn't he?
Yeah. Should have read that the other day.
I signed him on Chapman 0304 for Palermo.
What a scrap that'd be. Yaya versus Conte.
Ooh.
Anyway, Quadra.
Oh, this is you said you're trying to give your like a bit of balance as well. I kind of tried to like do the same thing rather than just putting loads of attacking midfielders in.
But yeah.
I can't not put Zidane in. For like, I know it was at Juve for like 5 seasons. Won the league there, like won World Player of the Year whilst he was at Juve as well. But like you said about national tournaments, I suppose that could be argued it was his performances with France. And the other player I've put in is Andrea Pirlo.
Oh, fuck me.
Oh, my God.
Oh, see, I was proper going Busquets, Roy Keane.
It's a solid six there.
I could argue more for Pirlo than I can Zidane.
I had Zidane in brackets. Sorry, well, in brackets.
To be honest with you,
I
actually had I actually had De Rossi and Perlo with Zidane in brackets. But then I thought, I'll stick Perlo and Zidane in. Perlo, again, played till his late 30s. AC Milan said he couldn't do it anymore. He went to Juve, then won the league with them for like the next five seasons.
But it wasn't strong then, though.
Touché, Dylan. Touché.
Can you imagine Perlo and Modric just two loud midgets just bipping passes about fucking time?
Dictate the pace every game.
Neither of them would leave the centre circle. They'd just be pinging balls.
Just getting megged for days in the centre circle.
That basically would be it, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
You'd have pretty much.
Pirouette turns, megs, and Hollywood
balls.
You'd
probably have to get them an unbelievable holding midfielder to run. And then he just was like, well, just give us the ball then.
That's right. Should have been 4-3-3. Could have done that then.
He was should have.
Oof.
Oh, I'm pure stuff. I don't know how I forgot Perlo until you said it, but now he's like the one I'm. I was going Busquets Keane, and now I'm Busquets Keane or Perlo.
Busquets Perlo for me.
So it would put Busquets in.
I'd definitely put Busquets in.
I don't get Busquets.
Oh God, here we go.
No, I'm not going on a rail.
How do you not get it?
I just don't. Just
play for them now, man. They can't let him go. He's that good. They want to wank themselves dry over Pedri and Gavi, and he's like, all right, well, can't not get because he just dictates every game.
The fact that he was like in a midfield with Xavi and Iniesta and like looked like he belonged as well.
And he's outlasted them
in that three. And well, yeah, he's played longer than them. And he was like the pivot for them to like do what they did.
I don't think there's anyone else out of the six that I don't think he would out. I don't think
he's starting
anyone
else. Tonight. There you go. The Champions League, they need to win, and he's starting in 20 minutes time against Inter. With Gavi and Pedri, I've just slated, but you know.
I don't think anyone else in the other five can't do what he's doing. You know what I mean? Like, I think everyone can do that.
If you're going to say, like, stand and do five-yard passes, then just be it.
No, I'm not saying stand about and do passes. I'm not going to say stand about and do passes. Because obviously there's more to it. You don't play that amount of games and win everything that you've won without having some form of ability.
Look how high up the pitch Iniesta and Xavi used to get. Like, they seem to be, like, all the time in the opponent's
half.
Yeah,
it's
because of Busquets that we're able to do that.
Just because I just don't like Barcelona, and I didn't like Barcelona then either. So it's probably why I'm not going for it. But
it will be very weird, by the way, as well, if we have an all-time team and there's not one Barcelona. I'm just saying. It's a bit weird. Considering they are either the best team ever.
Fuck the listeners.
I'm Busquets and then I'm Keane Perlo. Fucking, that's hard.
You've both gone Busquets, so I'm out on Busquets. It's a democracy. It's not a dictatorship, is it?
Ramos was a dictatorship, but look. I was Kim Jong Un when that came to Ramos. Like,
bliss.
Right, Busquets, Perlo, Keane. Oh my God, that is a pure coin flip. I'm just letting you know. I've reeled out Modric, Toure, and Zidane. It's Perlo, Keane. Everyone will be screaming Zidane, won't they? Listening.
I can see a few people screaming Modric, to be fair.
It's a team.
A lot of people won't even look at Keane, I don't think.
I tell you what Modric has got that no one else that we mentioned does have. An outside of the boot pass.
Yeah, he doesn't need his left foot. Does not lead his left foot.
Or finish. Outside the boot pass and finish.
That's what I mean. much as I like pure, as much as I want Keane in there, I can't see it happening. I can't see it happening because everyone else is just
right. We need to make a decision. We've got four more spots to do.
For me, it would be wish getting either Pirlo or Modric. To be fair, as much as I want Keane in there, but you've got to look at it.
Like, looks like we're going with Pirlo.
Two Pirlo or Keane. Players,
so Busquets and Pirlo, they're the two making things happen in the middle of the park.
Yeah, when I'm writing it down, though, it doesn't look right. Sorry, but we'll stick with it. Oh, we don't talk confident.
I've pure not done the Premier League justice here, like, because it's a Farmers League, eh?
It's not, it's just overrated. She's got loads of money. Oh, I feel pure shit about Roy Keane. I'm not going to lie.
I do feel a little bit heartbroken, like, I'm not going to lie.
I feel fine, to be honest.
I'm really not in there. But it's fine. It's fine. I'll have to fight another day.
I think I flipped. I think I went Roy Keane.
The bus getting Keane.
Roy Keane was unbelievable. He's the only one that I would argue could take the captaincy off Ramos.
He's an engine, like.
To be fair.
But Pirlo barely ever sprinted.
You do need somebody in midfield that can take the game by the scruff of the neck.
I've shot Roy Keane.
And
I took it out. It, just writing it down, Jay, didn't look right. I've changed it. It's Roy Keane and Sergio Busquets.
All right. Fine by me.
Yeah, sweet.
Imagine the stick we're going to get on social media.
do you want to go on the wings or do you want to go on the cam?
Go cam.
Cam. Right.
Cam. Nath, you can go first, mate. You haven't been first in a bit.
Right, my cam. Premier League cam. Frank Lampard.
Shout
goals. Goals. Love Frank goals. Lampard. And people can sit there the whole Gerard, Lampard, Toast Granner argument. Lampard all day. Lampard all day.
I don't think Scholes belongs in that argument, to be honest.
Fucking hell. It's De Bruyne now, I think, like, genuinely.
Yeah.
If you'd have said De Bruyne in this, I'd have been like, yeah.
I wanted to, but goals.
Yeah.
Frank Lampard and goals just go hand in hand.
Well, if it's goals you want.
Here you go. It's kind of pull my heartstrings. What are you saying?
King of Rome. Francesco Totti.
Who's going to do that?
It's not wrong, though.
What is it? It's like, I was looking at it the other day. Is it second most Serie A goals of all time?
Yeah, by Gigi Riva. 251. I think it was on a Golazzo podcast, like Gab Marcotti said, if he had like one more season, he'd have probably done it.
Oh, he definitely would have done it. Even in that last season, he was popping up with important goals.
Mm. And Riva played in like the 60s, 70s, where like, you know, Pelé scored 1,002 goals. So he did it in a modern day game, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and majority of his career played like as a cam. Obviously, the older that he got, the further forward he moved, as tends to happen. But I love him, mate. Absolutely love him.
I knew you were going to say him as well. Like that's why I went Lampard. Like,
could have signed for anyone at any point.
Just go strong.
Turned down Real Madrid in 2000. Well,
I'll throw my curveball in because I love Totti, but I also love this guy, and I know Jay loves this guy. The only negative would be it'd be the total opposite views. He didn't get enough goals. Andreas Iniesta.
I thought you were going to say Guti for me there.
Ah, Guti, fucking. He'd be putting on a plate for Cafu, man. Sixth King, moving. No, 442 appearances, I'd say negative 35 goals, but 9 La Ligas, 6 Copa del Reyes, 6 Spanish Super Cups, 4 Champions Leagues. Argument, he should have got Ballon d'Or in 2010.
World Another reason we should goal. Have went 4-3-3.
Yeah, it'd have been... Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Nath, I love Lampard, but you're out. It's Totti or Iniesta. You're out. You know you're out. Sorry.
Lampard's better than Iniesta.
I've always said... Fuck, what?
Goals, mate? Goals?
Iniesta's, like, the best central midfielder of our lifetime, to be honest.
Calm. Lampard, goals.
Oh, this is fucking... This is minging.
Try and do what I can for Premier League, man. Flying the flag for the Prem.
No, it's a great, it's a great, it's a great pick.
If I picked De Bruyne, it wouldn't have changed anything, would it?
It would have made it harder, I think. It wouldn't have changed this, but...
It would have made it harder.
There they are then.
I'd put De Bruyne ahead of any other cam in the Prem history now. It's fucking unreal. But that's not the argument. That's not the argument. Yeah. Iniesta or Totti?
You got to spit your dummy and throw other players in now that you might have fought on them.
Nymphs. Nymphs. Fat Frank.
Well, go on then, if you get to pick Totti or Iniesta.
Yeah, it's got to be Totti, really, isn't it? I'd look like an absolute moron if I said Iniesta or Totti.
I'll happily settle with that because my love for the man, but Iniesta needs a special mention being the first name on the bench in this team, mind.
If we went 4-3-3,
yeah,
I would have had I would have squeezed Totti in as a forward because it could have.
I think it's just safe to say the Premier League's all done cat.
Totally, like...
Although my front three, I think I've got good competition with my front three here.
Right, so we'll go with where do we start on the defence? Right, we'll go right wing. Go on then, Jay.
Mine's not that he like. He's not a winger, but he's like played on the right. Definitely for Sam. A little bit before our time. And he's definitely played there for Milan, although he's not a right winger. Clarence Seedorf.
No, you can't just shoot him out on the wing because you love him.
I haven't got any wingers, man. How can I? To be fair, I'm conceding it straight away because I couldn't think of.
You'd have better been putting up Totti on the wing. Right, you're out.
Yeah. No. It's a one position I struggled with, eh? Honestly, it's a one position I struggled with.
I'm trying to think off the top of my head there, like, quite hard, though, isn't it?
Etu. Come on, Etu.
I was going as, like, 4-2-3-1. So I'm not putting...
Agreed to it.
You know, pushes and brought a forward.
Not going about the formation now. We could have all picked our own formations, to be fair.
I think we always have done in the past.
Yeah, but we wouldn't have done it for this.
It would have been pure difficult. That we'd have been arguing about formation.
Yeah,
but now, nah, exactly. Like, I'd happily admit I'm out. I've sneakily tried to shoehorn somebody in the team.
When you said Seedorf, I was like, right, sorry, I'm at least coming second.
Go on, Nath.
Right, inverted, right sider, left footer, Manchester City in Spain, David Silva.
Oh, you've won. Yeah, you could have argued him for Cam then, maybe as well, but I know what you mean, because when City played that weird 4-4-2, that's where he played, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. And I like the invertedness of it. I like both that can cut inside and get like a sneaky pass or a shot off. I like that.
Silva was the best player of the Premier League.
Unreal.
The whole time he was in the Premier League.
Phenomenal.
Right, this was actually my only position where I was undecided on. I wrote both down, wrote both their stats down. So I undecided I was. One I absolutely adore, and one was just mint. Do you know what? I'm not going to win. I'll go with longevity because I love him. David Villa.
Thought you were going to say David Villa. Fair play.
Yeah. His stats were unreal. I've gone through them. 38 in 80 games for Sporting Heon. 32 in 73 for Zaragoza. 108 in 166 for Valencia. And then 33 and 77 for Barca. And even when he was old as shit, still trying to play on the wing. 13 and 36 for Atleti. Won the Copa del Rey with three different teams.
He's pure underrated footballer, isn't he?
It's really, I think he's underrated. Helps me get him in the team because for Barca, he played on the wing when they had that inverted 10 for Messi.
Mm. Yeah.
Because he was definitely an out-and-out striker at Valencia.
If he just played out-and-out striker, he'd been unbelievable. Yeah, if it was... So the only reason I fit him in, like, I got him on the wing because I wouldn't have above my striker. But I dog. My other one was Bale. Gareth Bale. 81 in 76.
David Silva scoring... not David Silva. David Villa scoring every continent as well. We've done that in a quiz, haven't we?
Yeah. Yeah, six out of the seven continents, because he wants to score on Antarctica.
him and Les Ferdinand.
Kevin Campbell. It was Kevin Campbell. was it Kevin Campbell?
Bill Graham.
I forgot about that fucking hell.
It was a quiz we did. Three players. It was Kazuki Honda, David Reed, I can't remember the one, but Bill thought it was Kevin Campbell.
Because he played in Turkey. That's still in Europe.
I think we're going with David Silva there, though, aren't we?
Yeah.
Aye. Oh, all day.
Beautiful. Oh, yeah, he's a great shout.
Premier League.
Left wing.
I have got a genuine left-sided midfielder for this one, lads. Don't worry.
Oh, is it not like Yap Sam or something?
No. Inverted advanced centre-half.
Have you horned in Costa Curta?
Go on, the Newton starts if we just totally derailed you on the last one.
Yeah.
Another that was right-footed on the left-hand side, cutting in like you enjoy, Nath.
Yes.
Ballon d'Or winner. Pavel Nedved.
Good shout.
Get part of that Lazio side that won the Scudetto for the first time since the early 70s.
Won got Scudetto. Some railroad three times off Cafu.
So it was. Cafu's like the best right back of all time, so
bit of friction in the dressing room there already.
Stuck with Juve when they went down as cheating and went back up. Fucking unbelievable player, Pavel Nedved. Could play on that left hand side, could play through the middle. Loved a worldie. And had great hair.
Player? Inverted, so left sided, right footer. French, Mr. Baba Boom, Thierry Henry.
Great shout. Because he played there. Thierry Henry. I could put him there for the league and all.
Thierry Henry.
He's the best player to play in the Premier League.
He's the best player to ever play in the Premier League.
Yeah.
Hands down.
Ooh.
To be fair, you could still play that as a 4-3-3 if you had Henry on the left and Silva on the right.
Thierry
Henry,
mate.
Right, I'll go my then. My also is a right-footed left winger. The most disrespected footballer of our generation. He's better than Ronaldinho, Neymar. He was unbelievable at Barcelona.
Hey, to be fair, he was
unbelievable.
When I went to see him, he was the only one of the three that didn't score of him, Messi and Suarez, but he fucking ran the game. He was absolutely phenomenal. Like,
yeah.
He's got one of those faces that you can't help but look at him and think, you're an absolute twat.
And
the way he carries on as well at times, that doesn't help his cause.
His antics in the 2018 World Cup didn't help, did it?
What, he broke his back?
Who went out with that Colombian right back went through the back of him?
Yeah.
Even in like the group stage and that, he was being a bit of a...
I know, but this is why I say, like, disrespected. Like, he got booked the other week for rainbow flicking someone.
Yeah, well, that's France.
Why is that a thing? If Ronaldinho did that, it'd be like on Times Square big TV. I get what you mean, he's a bit of a prick. I'm not saying he isn't, but what a footballer, man. Jesus Christ, what a footballer. Probably ruined himself going to France, happily admit that. But
on a team guy, didn't he? His time at Barcelona he was unreal.
Mm. Oh, that is a tough one.
Thierry Henry, mate.
I'd argue that Henry, like, I know he drifted out wide, but like his pomp at Arsenal was playing as a striker.
Striker, yeah.
Not asked.
I'm just trying to narrow down the choice.
I've put him there because my top, my one at the top, I couldn't have not put him out of one in. Thierry Henry, though.
I thought you'd have Henry up front, you know. I thought that'd be high, because I know you're not going to pick Shearer.
I thought it would have been Henry up front.
Not even in the picture was Alan. No.
I'm not letting go of Neymar, by the way. Unbelievable footballer.
I think because of the position and because Henry, for me, in my opinion, played his best years playing as a striker that would drift wide but wouldn't start the game on that left-hand side. Pires would start the game on the left. Inverted winger. I've got to go with Neymar. And that's not me picking Neymar over Henry as a whole. It's just because of the position that we're filling.
It's not me either. It's that argument. He was up front for Arsenal. And we said we were basing it on... You could base it right wing if it was Barca. And I'd still pick Neymar for time at Barca over Henry at time at Barca.
I wish I could do the lip thing.
If you don't...
imagine legend. No, fair play.
He is, but if it was a striker, I'd struggle to argue against it. He's probably my favourite neutral footballer of all time that played in the Premier League.
Fair play. Neymar's locked in.
Neymar.
Sound. Love it. Right, so out and out, number 9. You need the goals from your goal machine.
This
could be
a gut wrench.
Yeah.
Picking my... Yeah,
I think it'd be harder for you, Jay. Than me and Nip. I only had two. Oh, I had three.
I could have had a few, but only one entered my head.
I could have had
17.
Heart-wise, I have a lot. And even
now, you could have an 11.
I've just thought something. You could have put Kaká on the right wing ahead of Seedorf. The amount of people you could have put in just because you wanted to say Seedorf.
Was it because I wanted to say Seedorf? I was trying to think. You know what drove me to Seedorf? Was his position his position on Champman 0102 was attacking right midfield centre. I'd always associate Kaká playing through the middle because marauding runs like
not fade off. Sorry, go on. Right. Who wants to go first then?
I don't because I'm still undecided to be honest.
I'll go first. Wayne Rooney.
Great.
As an all-round footballer, I think you could put him anywhere on that pitch in that 11.
It'd
be unreal.
So disrespectful.
He's not goal scorer. He's not even going to stop goal scorer for long, man. Because I think Harry Kane will do it. I think
He's so disrespected.
He's Man United's top goal scorer. He dare say he's probably the best footballer that we've ever produced on this show. He's that good.
Because he looks like a fridge. No one wants to like him.
Well, he didn't score in World Cups, though, did he? He's a shitty mint.
He's the best we've produced.
He was our hope at like 18 in 2004.
He's the best we've produced. Easy. I know everyone wants to do the Gaza thing, and I'm not saying it because you enjoy, but Gaza had like the humour thing that Rooney didn't have. Rooney is just...
Gaza also had a drink problem.
Wayne
Rooney's had his things, but
I think it's one of them, isn't it? People from different generations will argue different players. Like the older you are, you've seen more. And like, I mean, I obviously get very nostalgic when talking about Italian football, for instance. And sometimes let my heart roam ahead. But for me, Rooney's the best player that England have ever produced. Definitely in my lifetime, 100%. I can't say for like the likes of Bobby Charlton and stuff like that. I've maybe seen about 4 clips.
Yes, you
and they're all World Cup goals. But
old football is dog shit. Yes, you can.
Wayne Rooney, mate.
Right, I've got R9, Ronaldo. Didn't say I could
that
have that one.
Jay's gone for.
I don't mean there was a chance me and Jay could have the same one. I thought about Benzema and I thought about Raul.
Benzema's a pincher.
He's no more like Modric. Can't deny it now. He's one of the best strikers to ever live. fucking unbelievable. But Ronaldo, especially that Barca year when you watch clips, man, 34 goals in 37 appearances for Barca.
One season as well.
Yeah, and then he got 83 in 123 for Real Madrid. He probably, we don't really know about injuries, but probably because he wasn't as decorated.
The thing is, club-wise,
I know he won the World Cup, I mean, like, club-wise, he wasn't as decorated.
People always say, like, what could have been if it wasn't his injuries, but, like, people forget, like, what he's done. Yeah. And it could have been so much more.
So good, man. And now he's a sporting director, you know, or owner, whatever he is in Mallorca. Yeah, pure fat. Loving it, loving life.
But, well, we do have the same striker.
Same striker, right?
Yeah.
No back goal.
I thought he'd have him or back goal.
They were the two. But fucking
insert Ronaldo is like Barca Ronaldo, innit? It's different level.
Both those spells are before his knees fell to pieces.
The world was literally ice feeding.
97-98, 25 goals in 32 games. Won the UEFA Cup. That was the only trophy won within there. But like, when you see the footage and he's playing in Russia and they're playing on like that bog for Inter, and he's still dribbling and he's still like, you hear the argument that like what with four pins to talk about George Best, oh, they didn't have those carpet pitches, like no, they didn't do that. I was like, look at Ronaldo, like he was phenomenal, and he was putting like Nesta, Cannavaro, he was like putting them beside. I loved him. Like, Battistuta was probably my favorite striker, favorite number nine of all time. But
Ronaldo's a striker, isn't he? Ronaldo's a player.
I love that video of like the France scored in '98, where like Thuram.
Like,
all he does is go to that side or something, and like Thuram and Desailly just stare at him like, you've got no idea.
Well, they're saying, aren't they, when they played against him and they were like, you think he's going that way, then he goes that way, and they're like, you just can't if it wasn't for what happened the night before that World Cup final, the seizure, 98, then it might have been a different Ballon d'Or winner that year. It might have been third year in a row for him. He won two Ballon d'Ors before he was 21. And then won it again after his like horrific injuries. The footage of it when it happens, because it's like mid step over, isn't it?
Against
Lazio, I'm sure.
So I've wrote down Ronaldo, because if I'm gonna come second, I'm gonna come second to him.
Yeah, I don't think you'll have an argument.
We'll get loads of grief if we picked Rooney over him.
It was like the 25th anniversary of that goal against Compostela the other day, and it like popped up on Twitter. The one where he gets it from the halfway line when he plays for Barca. Fucking good.
PSV and Wally. Like, I know it's boring, but like,
so, lads, the team, our all-time 11 of Serie A, La Liga, and Premier League goes like this. Obviously, people will argue, but well done. In goal, Gigi Buffon, right back, Cafu. Centre half, the captain, Sergio Ramos. Next to him, Vincent Kompany. Left back, Paolo Maldini. Two holding mids of Roy Keane and Sergio Busquets. Three behind the striker of David Silva, Francesco Totti, and Neymar. Behind Ronaldo, R9.
Three out of 11.
Oh, Neymar and Ronaldo. That'd be summer.
I'm chuffed Roy Keane's in there.
He's hitting them Brazilians in the dressing room doing jogging.
Imagine like samba dancing where you've got like three Brazilians in that side. Then Keane will be like sat shaking his head in the corner.
So much samba music getting played on that stereo and dancing about in that dressing room. All he wants to do is read the program and drink his tea.
It's a bit over the top.
Ronaldo's figures for like his stats for Real Madrid as well, like 83 goals in 127 league games, with shot to bit knees and about a stone overweight.
Yeah, I would duty was putting the mouth on a plate.
Yeah, it was so good. I'm gonna go and watch some Ronaldo videos.
So yeah, that's it. Our team drops it up, eh?
Right, take care, lads.
See you in a bit.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Ciao.